Definitely solid nerfs. As you pointed out, he's still a pain in the arse. Scorched Earth, still a fantastic spell, and people don't want to play against him, apparently. I'm also a bit surprised. I think both teams probably don't want to play against him, but Monkey Business have played him a bunch on Moon and had like an 85% win rate on him, so.
Yeah, and Stark also not wanting to play against the IO from OG.
Yep. I think these teams probably, like most of the teams in the scene, know each other pretty well, but just because they have some members who used to play together for a long time, I imagine that you know each other and your draft styles pretty well. But it's going to be the Tusk ban out. Fun, or maybe not so fun, facts on Stark is this patch, they only have an 11% win rate.
How many games is that over?
Oh, they've only... I mean, I think it's more than 20, but they're not doing so great on this patch.
I actually thought it would be an alright patch for them, because they play pretty aggressive Dota, so when you get a snowball rolling, you generally win in this patch.
But maybe they just
make bad decisions. Because I've seen their laning stages so well.
Dire team pick.
Whenever I see them play, they do win, and then maybe they just make one or two mistakes.
Okay, yeah. But apparently not a favorable patch for them. I don't know either. Last time I saw them, they were doing pretty well, and then it feels like they got rebranded as, or they got picked up by Stark and had a bit of a rough time. Either way, we got picks flying out. OG pick up the Shadow Fiend Dazzle. Both heroes they're super comfortable with. And something I really like about OG is their flexibility, how they sometimes put No-Tail in mid, sometimes put Miracle in mid.
Yeah, I think they're just both comfortable doing... both roles. No-Tail's normally on like the two hero though, Miracle's generally the one. I expect him to be the Shadow Fiend.
Yeah, he definitely has many, many more Shadow Fiend games than No-Tail seems to, with a nice whopping 72% win rate. So,
considering how often that hero's picked, that's pretty high.
Yeah, he has 11 games on it this patch, which is a crap ton, because it's normally banned out as well. Like, just given its pick ban rate, really nice. And they go with the Darkseer on Stark. Pretty strong. He got a little bit of a nerf loss patch, but still a really powerful offlaner. How do you feel about this Gyrocopter first round pick, though? I'm not loving it.
I feel like it's a comfort hero for them if they pick that early, not wanting it to get banned out in the second stage, or maybe they feel like it's not giving too much away by picking it. As you say, it's not the best first pick, for sure. Giving Radiant Shadow Fiend, not having like a mid hero to deal with it, kind of awkward.
Yeah, I mean, there's potential, although they already picked up the Darkseer. They can always go with something like the Lina, which fares pretty well against the Shadow Fiend. It's hard, though, to get something that'll catch up to him, and with their options for something like a Clockwork at pretty much nil, it is a bit concerning.
Yeah, they're going to need some initiation, as you say. With no Clockwork in the pool, they're going to rely on probably a support or their mid to be able to start these fights, because Darkseer's not going to be able to do that, even if he has a blink. He's not the ideal initiator.
Yeah. So, the Jug ban out as well, not wanting to deal with that early push, and the Wyvern. Funny story, kind of unfortunate. I'm pretty sure I looked up Stark. They've played a lot of Wyvern, but they have a 0% win rate. But I can understand banning it out anyway. You're like, this hero can cause a lot of issues. Why not get ourselves an easier win if possible?
Well, if they have an 11% win rate, they probably don't win with too many heroes. It doesn't mean play them.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah.
And also the Meepo ban out for No-Tail.
Yeah, I was wondering about this one. I had a really hard time pulling up the stats on bans, because it's obviously much easier to get picks. So I wasn't super sure how many times it's banned out against them, but we've discussed this before. I just feel like you have such an advantage when you have a player on your team who picks a hero that everyone's like, yeah, no, we have to ban this. So
Dark have alright heroes at the moment to deal with him. They could definitely cough ball. Like a few disabled heroes, like you say, Lina, Earthshaker maybe, and they would both fit well in their lineup, so Radiant, I think they just don't want to have to deal with it, because Dazzle Meepo can do a lot. Shadow Fiend's also to deal with.
Yeah.
You have so many threats on the map.
And OG doing a really good job of banning out anything that could at all be a pain in the ass to Shadow Fiend, right? Spirit Breaker, one of the heroes that can actually bring some sort of initiation onto him mid lane from anywhere, the Wyvern, who would start mid, maybe level 1, help out whoever's the real mid in getting those early lost hits and just giving Shadow Fiend a rough time. This is looking like a really nice chill Shadow Fiend game.
Yeah, so far it's pressure him and having the Dazzle, who's probably going to be stacking and hanging around mid, just give you like a lot of confidence. You just feel like the game's going to go well when you know you're not going to get camped by 3 heroes. Definitely change if they pick up like a Bounty Hunter or something that sits maybe a Bane. No, there's options.
Yeah, Bane's also really popular this patch, seemingly. I mean, he was getting picked up a little bit last patch, and it feels like he's just gotten really popular this patch as lockdown that goes through BKB and so on. And I just realized that's like a raccoon from No Tail's picture.
I like it.
Raccoons have tails. It's a problem. Either way, getting themselves up the Earthshaker. Do you think this is a support or an offlane Earthshaker?
I think it's going to be offlane. Support would just be... It wouldn't mean they have to pick quite a strong safe lane that kills the Darkseer on their own. Mm-hmm. Definitely heroes that can do that. I feel like Dazzle's going to be around mid. Or maybe the Shaker's around mid instead if they support, but I don't think it's as good. I'd expect it to be offlane. It could be either, though. At the end of the day, it's just what they prefer, how they feel favors them.
Also, a funny thing about OG, I don't think they're doing it here, but they've actually picked Earthshaker before for Miracle. I think... No, it wasn't. Maybe it was No Tail. They've picked, like, this weird core carry Earthshaker before in at least one of their games, because I got this really weird stat where it's like an Earthshaker with a million kills in farm, and I looked it up and I was like, oh, okay, well, that's fun. But don't know how serious that game was. But either way, Jakiro from Stalk, and this is something that's also been growing in popularity, especially, I don't know if you've seen these games, but the Jakiro Brewmaster combo has been getting really popular.
Mostly from OG, though, isn't it?
No, Alliance also ran it yesterday.
Oh, okay.
I think out of the teams which have had successful Brewmaster performances, which are pretty small, because we've been casting a lot of Brewmasters that just can't seem to steal the deal in the games, the ones paired with Jakiro seem to be doing much better.
Jakiro just gives you the ability to take towers as well. And he's not high farm priority hero, so he can just get his levels and he can still be impactful. When you have a core like Gyro and Darkseid, you don't take powers too effectively early. And Jakiro just bolsters ability to more after you win a fight.
Yeah. And a Rubick pickup always. And a couple of nice things to steal here, although you're a bit light on the... I mean, you're going to get Ion Shell on Surge pretty reliably. I guess Gyrocopter has good stuff. I don't know how I feel about the Rubick having the vacuum, though, just because it... Radiant team. Although, by the time the Rubick 6 should be high enough level that you can steal a couple good things from the docks here.
Just good hero for them here. It gives some... Yeah, support that can give them another form of initiation. Because Earthshaker on his own is similar to Dark, so you don't necessarily want to be the one going first. You want to be there to counter-initiate, or just... Fisher from long range and someone else go in, like the Rubick.
And then the Alk, who has seen a steady drop off in pick and ban. And the A ban out from OG. So this is kind of interesting. I mean, they don't have room for it, clearly. And also, folks who are watching, tell me if my mic volume changed too much. I'm playing with a new setup. So, but the A ban out, normally folks want that. I guess OG deciding they don't have space for it. Yeah, and then the Husker ban up. Maybe they were planning on running the Dazzle Husker, trying to sneak that one in.
Yeah, that's smart from Boogie, making sure it's not an option. Maybe OG just putting it out there, like, forcing them to the Husker so they get whichever carry they actually wanted, but it could go either way. Bit of mind games.
Always fun to see this.
That could have been really good.
Oh yeah, I agree with you. It would have been fantastic. Necrophos filling a similar role from the standpoint of doesn't want the AA around. And certainly is one of the few who's pretty damn good at shutting down an Alk's farm, because you can take him off the map for a while, which gets rid of that lovely Grievous Greed.
So. Yeah, if you manage to take him out late game as well with no buyback, which he generally has because he has money, it's a really big deal. Yeah. Not normally the tankiest of heroes.
Yeah, because of Grievel's greed.
Or an Octarine.
Yeah, because of Grievel's greed, Alchemist has awful stat game. So, expecting you to own all of those stats through money. And now, Stonk, last pickup here, you got any favors looking for a strong support? Although it could be an Alc support. We've seen this a few times where folks make it look like mid-Alc and then a surprise support Alchemist.
Yeah, I can't remember who it was, but they did like a Darkstair Alc duel off. Spams the wave out. The Darkstair slash levels at all, so that's an option. But I think it would be alright as a mid hero here. It's just what they're comfortable with. Mm. Because of that, I can't really say where they want to go. They have like a lack of an initiating hero, but if they just fight and hours afterwards hero, they don't necessarily need it right now. Disruptor.
And I say as I lose Dota, the Disruptor, this is, I don't know if it's as good here. I feel like Rubik's now super happy, you know? You can definitely silence, that'll hamper a lot of Necrophos' damage, and if you can get off that Static Storm as the Earthshaker jumps in, maybe you can stop something, but generally you're going to get off that Echo Slam with its instant cost point before Disruptor has hope of that.
Well, I think the big reason they picked it with the Darkseer, and you can also use it as a way of defending or taking favorable fire. Purpose 5 on OG, which you're probably going to look to do fairly early when go for it this game. But if they group up, they take out, or they back off, you have to you glimpse one of them back, get a free pick off. And that's like a way of getting something out of tower defense. Managed to get the tower. Or option.
100%. We've already got early ward rotations from both teams. Moon didn't actually manage to get his down, and okay, see ya. Making sure to have a good eye on where potential ward placement is. Let's get around to introducing the teams. On Stalk, we've got Boogie on Gyrocopter, Nempi on Alchemist, Valix on that Disruptor. Oxy is going to be played up by Trixie, which leaves us, okay, see ya, on the Jakiro.
Over on OG, we've got Fly on the Dazzle, who TP'd on bottom, placed early ward, which did end up scouting the ward the Darkseer placed. Crit on the Rubik, Miracle on his Shadow Fiend, Moon on the offlane Earthshaker, and Notel on the Carry Necro.
Okay, so I have to be honest, I've been casting a lot of America's Dota. I haven't had as many opportunities as I'd like to see these folks, but I know Miracle Shadow Fiend is very good. Do you think he's just going to dominate this mid lane, and what does Stock need to do to shut him down?
I definitely think he has the edge, because Elk can't really contest. He just gets enough souls from raises and have a hard time. But to shut him down, come gank, I guess, if the Alc opts to go for stun, but I think it's just going to be maybe look to contest the stacks with that player, so you don't let him too far ahead of you.
Yeah.
That's like their safest way of contesting his farm.
I'm really like super impressed they got this ward down. Like, crit came around and placed that, and I really like it.
I think they just read that the Hulk and the rest of the heroes were going bottom runes, so they had the ability to take top, and also getting the ward out, as you say, is really nice from crit.
And we've got our standard 2-2v2 mid that we always see. Miracle actually taking quite a bit of harass, but of course he has a salve anticipating these types of trouble. As you said, I'm not sure I have a lot of faith in Disruptor as a ganking hero for this mid Shadow Fiend, but it's certainly something where if Trixie is paying attention, he might be able to also snipe some stacks in the jungle that are being made up for Miracle.
This is a pretty solid game. There's not too much pressure on you. You just have to worry about the Darkseer, I think, because he's going to get quite a lot of levels bottom. OG can't really zone him out. No, he's already got level 2 off the first wave. He's not getting too many last hits, fortunately. That will change when he gets higher levels.
Yeah, at the same time, Necrophos getting much more farm, I think, than he would elsewhere, so you're probably okay with the trade, especially since even if your Doxia gets huge, you're also going to have this huge Miracle Shadow Fiend. Probably going to just go the Sanj and Yasha build. I imagine No-Tail is going to be the one forced into the mech this game.
I don't particularly like mech on Necro. run a mana intensive hero in the first place, and I feel like
I think he's Atos
on the hero. Yeah, like Atos, Octarine, Bloodstone items I think are better on the hero. And yeah. Shadowfiend was pretty good in general. It's not bad.
Yeah, it's a pretty fine pickup. I just wonder whether he'll go the like fast farming build, the Helm of the Dominator, Sanjin Yasha, or the mech. And as you pointed out, either of them can get the mech up early. Shadowfiend might even be able to get it up earlier, freeing up No-Tail to tank up in a bit more of a traditional sense. But we have Moon taking a lot of damage, being glimpsed backwards. Looks like Moon might be our first blood. Full Rocket Barrage to the face, and that is a very dead Bearman? Cowman? Cowman. Yeah, I don't know if they had the damage output. One more raise, can they hit it? A couple more auto attacks would do it too. But there are TPs in and bottling up, and now Crit, he needs to get out of there, but he's got a haster and he's gonna be A-okay. So failed gank mid, unfortunately.
Yeah, if he was level 2, that was pretty easy kill, but unfortunately he's been moving around the map a lot, not being able to get too much XP. Miracle's gonna be able to finish off his bottle here, and then you shouldn't worry too much about the assets for us.
He's playing really riskily here, and I think just understanding, as you pointed out earlier, there isn't going to be a Spirit Breaker charging in, there's no Clockwork or anything, he can play super low and feel safe, and worst case scenario, Fly will pick up a TP and Shallow Grave him, although looking towards Boots right now.
Yeah, not the ideal start for him, because he's had to ferry two selves out, but that's not a problem, no.
Yeah. On these lineups, it does feel like the late game is
actually
a bit...
Get a kill on Jakar here. Yeah. Body blocks.
Oh, can he wander away from them though? No, it looks like they should easily just be able to... Oh, they actually missed the raise! And now they're gonna have to do it with the auto attacks, but all the creeps get it. Jakiro trying to actually just one-to-one with Crit, trying to draw aggro. Oh, he goes down. Crit playing very patiently there. So... that was a super hard deny for Jakiro there. Like, you have to hope if you wait too long and man fight Crit, he's gonna get spells off of cooldown, which will just zap you down.
I don't think he was level 2 there though, so he only had the auto attacks to worry about from Jakiro.
And Miracle getting a bounty rune, and Alk, of course, getting that regen. Oh! Moon goes down again up top lane. I have to imagine you're pretty irritated that you didn't get the regen rune as well.
They might actually find Crit as well.
Yeah,
Crit by the field.
He's gonna use the lift. Will it give him? It does give him just enough, and the immediate TP back from Moon, who's only level 2. He's having a really rough time in this top lane. Oh, and a raise to finish off Nemphy in mid. I don't know how much you caught of that. I think Nemphy may be just coming up to the creep wave to last hit, and I saw the final raise.
I was watching. Time didn't get to see it.
Yeah. We can see on the net worth chart, Nemphy's still topping it, as you expect, an Alchemist 2, and then Gyrocopter up next. And yeah, Fly can't even really contest this pull away from Trixie, right? Trixie just comes in, has a grand old time. Unlike Moon, let's see if they can pincer him, but yeah, just gonna surge away.
Yeah, the only time he has to worry is when the Necro gets sick. Even then, he has to be fairly low for it to be a kill.
Yeah.
He can play as ballsy as he likes.
So, Nemphy has put up some points into that unstable concoction, so potentially some kills, but they have completely whiffed on finding this ward. I think they were pretty cognizant that there's a ward up there, but both this sentry and this sentry whiffing it.
Yeah, it's a bit of an unusual... generally expect them to be placed on these lines, so the sentry placement's pretty common from Stark, but OG's just going one more. I really like this placement, if you get it down without it being seen, slightly on off-docs, do all the vision you need.
Really helpful for a Shadow Fiend who, of course, wants to be able to throw out those raises, and yeah, you don't have to worry about the acid spray if you just raise down the creeps and then go put some right-clicks into Nemphy, but going for the top rune, don't think he's going to get contested. Let's talk timings for both of these lineups, because Shadow Fiend, Gyro, they feel like carries of equal carriness. I would say Gyro's a little bit harder. Ooh, and they're actually dewarding Stark's wards in mid. But I would say that the Gyro just has a bit more carry potential just because of flat cannon. But other than that, feeling like these lineups pretty even, and it's all going to come down to whether Trixie gets the big vacuum wall combo, whether Moon can get an Echo Slam of amazingness.
I think the biggest timing OG have is when Shadow can get some mech if he decides to go for it, and maybe Stark don't have like.
Oh, Trixie doesn't know that they were coming around the corner. A lift into a raise, and that's a very dead Mr. Potato Head. But no tail on the bottom lane. He is in trouble. The danger zone, as I like to say. He's gonna have a heal up. He's looking for some more time to buy so that he can heal. But he might just go down to the tower here. There's the heal out. Fly isn't in range for that shallow grave.
Might have
and that is gonna be rough.
First as a heal.
Yeah.
Actually
now Crit doing doing another lift, but Miracle has no interest, and Crit is actually taking a lot of damage, but gonna have a Shadow Fiend ready to raise, protecting him. So death's all over the place, and
really like that rotation from pushing the wave in, knowing that they just dewarded the ward from Stark, so they don't have any vision. You might think Stark should know about it, but this at the time it's not the most obvious. So,
yeah.
Unfortunately not able to get the stack, which I think was he ended up taking out, but they got the kill on him, so it kind of equalizes at the end.
And I think even if they were hunting the Alchemist, they're still pretty happy to get Trixie, just because it'll delay his mech, it'll delay his blink. So probably going a mech Arcanes first, and then going to work on that blink, which I think is one of the few things this Shadow Fiend has to worry about. But Trixie, having a much easier time in lane than Moon. I think you expect this out of these combos, but Moon's still getting decent levels for an offlane Earthshaker. And he's got boots.
Yeah, Stark's lane is really dangerous. Disruptive Gyrocopter to deal with most offlaners, so... done really well considering. The two deaths are a bit unfortunate, but he's getting a DS with Fisher spam, and he's getting his levels most importantly.
Yeah, two interesting things. It does look like No-Tail is going for that Rod of Atos. Really cheap way. I think the cheapest way to get that much int. Very cheap for 25 int. Also, we've got Alk rocking a Vitality Booster. Could just be for the early health boost, but could also be that he's doing some weird hot first build. I don't know.
I think who it was, but there was, maybe it was Black who did this. Maybe he didn't go for the Vit Booster, but I know he goes for, like, the Casual Sage Mask just for the regen, because it works so well with Chemical Rage. Really efficient. And then the Vit Booster just tanks you up a bit, deal with, like, a Fissure into Double Raise or a Lift into Double Raise. So then you can go for your Radiance and feel a bit safer.
Yeah.
He obviously doesn't want to go for the Creds instead, so he can get the Bots, which is why he goes for the Vit Booster.
Suddenly, as you pointed out, it is really scary when you've got this Shadow Fiend who hits like a truck, has raises. You don't want to be caught out alone against him. And I really like what both teams are doing. They freed up some lanes for their supports to try and get level 6 on both of them, having up those really powerful ults. So, we'll see what this next team fight brings. This Alk is level 8, while Shadow Fiend is level 11. I did not realize that that had happened. This is a pretty big experience deficit for Stark.
I think it's mostly just that Stark ended up giving their stacks to Trixie so he could get back on par. The Elk not being able to take them means Miracle huge advantage, and they're actually working up top. They should be able to get the gyro here.
Yeah, they're going in. They're stalking. They managed to land the Fissure, but it's on Okcia, and they're not able to connect after that. So maybe
Moon... they didn't go for that. Priority target.
Maybe Moon can act like he's not there, so yeah. I don't know if they'll be able to catch Boogie here, though. They're gonna probably wrap around. There's gonna be another Fissure. There should be a Telekinesis. There's gonna be some Razors. The Ice Moth catches one, but one more auto attack will do it, and they get it with the Razor. Now they're all backing out. Moon actually going around on the other side, seeing what else he can catch off, but there's gonna be no latch. And as you said, pretty happy with the high priority target they just picked up there.
And this is like really clean movement. They just pick up Shadow Fiend. They rotate the Dazzle top as well after this. Gets to kill, so they're gonna get the tower here. And Stark aren't in a position to trade because Intel's actually pushing him bottom, no one's mid. Stacks in the wood, so this is perfect to start for OG.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Now, do you think Stark has the late game if this potentially goes later, or are they in a pot of trouble being already about 3,000 experience behind?
I think Necrophos is the late game factor for OG. If you manage to get caught out, which they definitely can, when you have Earthshaker and Rubick, you have decent catch. You can get a big kill late game. You can
bottom tower is under
your 5v4. Bit scary if it starts to go late game, but they definitely have the Wombo combo.
Yeah.
G group up and mess up their position. That can capitalize on it, but don't think OG are gonna let that happen. Dyer's at least at this stage of the game. Pretty confident
now. Once they realize, or when Doxia gets a blink, and once they realize it on the lineup of OG, I imagine they'll stay pretty spread. Right now they're together, but there's no way for this Doxia to initiate on them. Yeah, vacuum into Static Storm could be amazing, with the cooldown to boot as well, but I don't know what the odds are of getting it off before a blink on the Doxia, and maybe Jakiro even needs a Yule's up first too.
And even if they have, like, the Lana supports right now, there's a mech on the Shadow Fiend. Always finishing Ascend as well. It's really hard for them. They're doing the right thing now. Trying to push in lanes. Way. Get a bit of control with this vision. I like that they're trying to block out the camps just to play like more efficient. But right now, OG will look for the tier 1 bottom as well after they push it out. This has been DD on Miracle.
Of course there is. Of course there is. He's almost got... He finished the mech. He's got his Sanj up. We'll be quickly approaching that Sanj and Yasha. And actually, they catch out OKZia. Unless he turns around and gets a really nice Ice Bolt. I don't even know. Oh, the return Ice Bolt and OKZia dying to his own abilities. That's always rough. And now if Valix isn't careful, he does manage to get out. The kinetic field not holding him for long enough. But they're searching on this lineup of OG. And if Trixie, yeah, the immediate TP out, I like that play. But instead, they'll just transition their DD into an early Roshan. Super easy to do with Presence of the Dark Lord. Oh.
I don't think they can Rosh if it was DD, so it's really unfortunate for Stark. However, this is something they could look to contest. Fortunately, they have no vision around here, and they only have level 1 vacuum. But this is like the one fight they, I feel like they could take early. They're not on that, so OG is just going to get this for free.
Yeah, Gyrocopter preferring to farm up. He's doing well. He's not doing poorly by any means, but I think a big problem. Oh, Miracle's actually taking a huge amount of damage. Static Storm dropped on him as well. They've got the telekinesis on Valix. They get him to the high ground, but Miracle, even with the mech, he's going to go down to Roshan, it looks like. They managed to pop the Roshan, and Miracle just gets it, but the immediately expended Aegis is not what OG wanted. An Ice Path up to top lane onto the Valix, and he also stole a spell there. Managed to get the kinetic field, but Fly, he's now in a lot of trouble, taking huge amounts of damage. Requiem of Souls comes out, but the Ice Bolt slowing down Miracle, and it looks like Fly is going to be lost in the exchange. They're trying to go for this stun, another high ground, but it doesn't end up working out. And now Fly, is he really going to get away here? Reaper Scythe onto Trixie isn't what kills him, but he gets out, and Fly, he gets another heal off. One more auto attack, the Fissure saving his life. Insane plays from Moon and Nempi, probably going to go down here despite the chemical rage. There's the heal, there's the raise to finish him off. I can't believe Fly didn't die there. He was on one health for most of that fight involving the Shallow Grave, but just the saves coming out from his teammate. I actually thought Crit had doomed him to die when he went for the cliff high ground, getting somebody stuck on the cliff instead of using the telekinesis for the secondary stun, but Fly just had way too much regen.
Yeah, he's really high level as well, so the low cooldown on the Shadow Wave is really hard to deal with this early in the game. The Stark is outside their Jara, they don't have the most damage right now, and I think he was zoned out most fights, so he could get in.
Yeah.
Considering they got the Aegis, I thought that was ideal for Stark, but then they forced their hand too much, and they went into OG when they had 5 heroes there.
Yeah.
Getting a bit too greedy.
Definitely felt like if they had Aegis and back, it would have been a very solid fight for them, and OG would have been upset, but now Nemphy, he takes the Fissure, they decide not to go in. Miracle actually pretty undecided, might be taking an unstable concoction to the face. Do they have enough damage though? And Miracle, he's just pounding into them. One more auto attack will do it. Now he's gonna work on Trixie. Ice Bolt suddenly slows him down, but then now finally with the creeps gone, all the Rocket Barrage is gonna do it. There's a static field. Miracle needs to get out of this one. Doesn't have mech, does have bottle charges though on the side, and No-Tailed also zoning. This glimpse back, I don't think Miracle even bloody cares. Two heals coming out, and he's suddenly back up, close to 1,000 health. This Shadow Fiend, I think, is out of control. He is almost double the Alchemist net worth, and that is an Alchemist with maxed, oh, not quite maxed, because he maxed the Acid Spray, but 3 points in Grievel's Greed.
Miracle's been playing really well this game, and it was... Oh, well, first round to Shadow Fiend, and Stark to not deal with it, knowing how well they play with this. So... Right now, they just have to play, like, trade game. If they try and fight, they're going to lose. They should know this. I hope they don't defend towers, like, outside their base. They're just going to have to hold the high ground, even without Aegis. Geo are extremely confident right now. And they have another Dio on Miracle, so they're going to probably try and save this one for the next tower. Maybe pour some damage on high ground with it.
And they've got enough time, it feels like, to take these outer tier 2s and then go for the next Roshan. If they just kind of slowly push up top lane, Roshan might be spawned by the next time. You could wait out Roshan, just take stocks jungle, really shut them down, make sure they can't get back in this game. And as you pointed out, I don't see fantastic high ground defense. Like, yeah, you've got acid spray and cooldown, like, you... No killing creeps.
They're cooldown based, so it's awkward for them. It takes too much time for them to cut waves, but it's how they have to play right now, unfortunately.
Yeah.
I'd expect OG to get a gem on fly as soon as he has some money.
If you're this Gyrocopter, are you now rushing BKB instead of something like the Sanjin Yasha?
He has to. Miracle just does too much damage in the fights. Even his right clicks are really scary at this point, but if you can get CC'd, you can at least get away a bit from those right clicks, stay in the fight a bit longer.
And I don't want to say it, but it does feel like it's a bit late for the Radiance on the Alc from the standpoint of he's not... We're not at a point where it's super useful.
He committed gold, and a lot of players don't like to change.
Oh, he actually misses the blink initiation on Valix, but that is going to be a very dead red dude riding a pony. Side. Oh gosh, that's so sad.
Yeah, I really like when teams... Like, we saw it the other day where they went track kill... here. I'm waiting on the Necrophus to get there. I just like that. It's more efficient. I know he wasn't.
Dire's tower has fallen. It's just so sad when you see it. Like, I'm a support disruptor. I want to get some mad levels because I'm level 7. Oh, what's that? I'm dead for 60 seconds. And yeah, here comes the high ground push. Miracle has a DD. He's going to walk out of the cooldown. No sort of lockdown for that. And they have it. It just feels like they're not stacking these, wasting the cooldown there. Yeah, it's not the longest of cooldowns, but they're not going to have it for this entire push. And how do you stop Miracle on your high ground? We've got some TP rotations coming back. There's going to be the Jewel Breath, but Miracle does not give a damn. Wants to use this DD as much as he can. He takes a bit of a stun, but now more and more sieging. And he's got folks buffing him up with the Medallion. He doesn't even care that much about this Acid Spray. Nempi wants to come in and do something, but this Radiance burn is really sad at this point.
Yeah, OG are playing this really well with their support position. Well, like, you just can't go on the Shadow Fiend because no, the Grave to save him. Moon isn't quite there yet, so the counter initiation is here, but they can't kill him. Moon has time to come over.
Yeah, they've got
pushing middle as well.
They've got the tower, they've got the unstable concoction out on Miracle, but again, just feeling like it tickles them. And with the amount of sustain this team outputs with the Dazzle and a Necrophos and the mech, which they still haven't used, Miracle decides to back a bit, might just farm a creep wave, you know, while farm some jungle. Actually, they are rotating No-Tail down, so I guess this is the end of the siege. I'm a bit surprised because it felt like they got the tower down. They could really easily just slow siege either Rax.
I think the Rax is a tiny bit riskier, but... You're at the point where they're so far ahead, if they just do what they're doing, they're actually going to find the Gyro here.
Yeah, they've caught him, and Echo Slam expended as well. Unfortunately, No-Tail isn't here, and Boogie is still alive, but he goes down very quickly to the auto-attack of the Shadow Fiend, and now let's see if Stock can mount any sort of defense, and no. Are you saying that the high ground's just a bit more dangerous because of the Static Field Doxia Vacuum combos that are easy to land when folks are up on your hill?
I think they could go for it, but at the moment, so far ahead, if they just chill a tiny bit, but they had a lot of gold on their heroes, like Crypt Boss stuff. Moon's working on one as well. No-Tail didn't have his BKB at the time, so maybe it was an item timing that they wanted to wait for. Now they're looking to go back to it, because they definitely can. I like the fact that they're not rushing it. They know they have control of the game right now.
Yeah. Really well-played game coming out of OG. And their heroes are really rich. Fly is rocking 1,500 gold right now. I mean, that shouldn't be. He's a support Dazzle. I'm expecting him to be poor. Rubick has a full 4 staff and an urn.
Level 3 vacuum to steal as well. He actually had that from the high ground push, so I expected him to spend gold on a blink. But this is just like the next level of Dota, where you realize you're in a position where you don't need the blink in the game now. If they can kill your Shadow Fiend, your blink doesn't. Whereas if you can force him away from like all their crap, then much better. But I like the picker.
Well, they already burned Glimpse, hoping to catch out Crit, and now they're going in deep. Use that Rod of Aetos. No Tail has a BKB. He doesn't care about your Static Storm. Now Trixie's going to be the next one to come in. He tries the Miracle, Vacuum Miracle through the wall, but there is not enough damage, and they're just going to work on the towers. No Tail's BKB is down, so maybe there's something they can do, but this wall placement, not ideal for this high ground siege, and these flat cannon shots just tickling the lineup of OG. Miracle's just pounding away onto that melee Rax, and I think it's going down an Ice Pulse to delay things, but Crit with the return Vacuum, and there's going to be a Requiem of Souls. Crit is getting low, but Miracle, he has his BKB up, and he gives no cares about what you're doing. Just gonna walk over to Trixie, finishes him off with a raise. They still actually haven't gotten the Rax. No Tail instead doing some work on the Shadow Fiend illusion. They should just work on pounding this down, but they're gonna wait the next creep wave, and I know they killed off some folks there, but a little bit surprised they just didn't finish off this melee Rax while they had the time in the base, but here it goes. They have everything they need. There are no buybacks on the lineup of stock, and they have gotten themselves an easy lane of Rax. Range gonna fall very quickly now. They've got a good ward up from stock. They can see all of this, but there's no response with their big ults being down.
I wouldn't be surprised if OE look to finish mid as well now. However, they do have some gods. They might do a similar thing where they let their items out on the chicken or go back to base.
Yeah, it's a really long spawn on Roshan, almost max length, folks, so I don't think they'll, well, they can wait for that, but it'll maybe give stock some breathing room, ability to get some items on their gyrocopter. But even with that, it just feels like the lineup of OG, they're super tanky on their frontline, as this Shadow Fiend rocking 1700, probably even 1800 if you change those boots to strength. And No Tail.
By this ward and a glimpse.
So a big, nice kill for them.
That's a decent amount of money. However, not going to matter if she managed to get this rush. I definitely think that's... I have to know the exact timing that it's up. With lanes pushed out and taken an immaculate team fight for this game to turn around.
Yeah, we were at about a 20,000 net worth lead, and probably 13,000 experience when this graph calms down. We are really far ahead on OG. And this is something you don't want to see. Your Alchemist, he's a hero that has to play from being ahead. This Alchemist is so far behind, 7,000 net worth behind this Shadow Fiend. This isn't how you play an Alchemist.
But this is what they should have known was going to happen. Maybe they didn't need to take the stacks in the woods. Then Elk would have gotten his farm a lot earlier. But when you put him mid against a Shadow Fiend, which they should have known was coming, he's going to lose far more, generally.
Yeah. Shadow Fiend not...
just more out of it.
Not easy. Now, you're a Miracle, you got 4k gold, what are you building up next?
Getting a butterfly, I think, because... So,
nobody really right-clicks you, though, on stock, either. Oh, and Memphi won't go down. Luckily, the Radiance mischance working out for him there. I don't know, I feel like, yeah, you can go with the butterfly, but no one's actually touching Miracle, you know?
I think it's, like, the most, like, defensive slash offensive item in general. You're getting an Aegis suit in your mind. You're thinking Skadi might be a bit too upper mean of damage output, so in between. West Dark looked smoke to get the buff. They're gonna find No Tail, but he can be TP. They might not even catch him.
And Moon just helping him out. No Tail actually thinking about going back in. He pops that BKB. He's just going to kill off OKSeeker, but he isn't able to. There's the heal. He finally goes down. Doesn't get the Reaper Scythe kill, but now they're working in on Nemphy, and they know he just TP'd out of top. He does have it back up cooldown finally, but not enough. And he gets right-clicked down, and now Trixie to follow. This is looking disastrous for Stalk. And I wanted to say something that, yeah, they call the GG. They had a bunch of smokes on cooldown on Stalk. This was like their first one used in ages. So...
they were never in a position to have to smoke OG though, because they were stronger at most points of the game, and they did pick heroes to fight before OG got their levels and their items. Yeah. Gotta be honest, I think this is just like OG completely outclassing.
Yeah, it definitely felt a bit like a stomp, and it's pretty, yeah, it was pretty one-sided, but hopefully lineup of Stalk can bring it back in this game too. That'll be coming up right soon. Either way, we hope for some good Dota. Once again, I'm Llama Down Under. I've been joined by PQMZ. You can give us feedback because we're always looking to get better at casting at Llama Down Under on Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook. PQ doesn't have the social